Hello and welcome. This is a scriptless version where I'm going to do this instead of doing it on the whiteboard. So there will be some hiccups, but that's the way it works. This section will be about network sniffing. So let's just sniffing. Basically, network sniffing is all about collecting packages so that we can either process them now or process them at a later stage. So the main idea about sniffing the network traffic would be to sniff the traffic. So let's do a quick simple network. So we have some sort of client that is connected to, in this case, a switch, and connect some sort of server. So when the client, if it makes a TCP connection to the server, we should see the CERN ACK and the acknowledge for the three-way TCP handshake, for example. So if you want to pick this up, you have basically three choices. You can either sniff on the interface of the client, you can sniff on the interface of the server, or you can ask the switch, or if you like, do it in transit. So this would be in transit, this would be on the interface. On interface. So the main idea here is that if you want to collect the traffic that that we talked about, then you need to be somewhere, you need to have some presence somewhere where you can actually sniff the traffic. So if we add an extra device to the system, we could add a C2 here, which is connected to the switch, then sniffing the interface here will not give you the traffic going from the client to the switch, since the way a switch works is that it basically sends it directly. So the TCP connection that we have between these two will not go to C2. So it will see broadcast traffic, but it will not see any it will not see the actual TCP connection between these two. So in order to do sniffing, we need to be where we are actually capable of sniffing traffic. We must have a physical presence. We cannot sniff in the Google data center unless we have something running in the Google data center. Okay, so let's do a new page here. So when it comes to sniffing, we have a couple of options. So when we have the device itself, it will send some traffic. You can have, this is again the interface, then you can have a process running here, a sniffing process that actually collects the data. So such a process will be able to collect all the packages from the interface. When I say interface, it might also be a virtual interface, like say a VPN connection or similar. And then we can decide what to do afterwards. If we save it as PCAPs or we have some online tool. But the important part here is that it sniffs the interface. So if you have some sort of web thing running here, it will actually do it before you get to the web thing. This is important because then we will get the, this one will decrypt, say HTTPS, and this one will not decrypt. It will see the encrypted, because it will look at this before the decryption happens as part of the web thing. Okay, so let's do the server side also. So over here we have the server, and we have the exact same scenario running here, where we have the what's this called? I guess, where we can have some sort of process running that sniff the traffic, and it will have the encrypted traffic, and it will again process PCAP or process. Okay. And then we'll probably have some web server service running here. This over here will be the browser. You can of course have some stuff sniffing around in the browser. We do that when we do our inspect, but that would not be the network traffic. That would be the decrypted traffic in the browser. That would be a different discussion. Okay, so if we so how can we, practically speaking, decrypt what's going on? So if we have a switch somewhere along the way, which we basically always has, we can, let's do this one. We can define something called a mirror port. In the Cisco world, it's called a spanning port, which basically is a port that copies the traffic. So, look, this guy. So we are still doing this, but we are copying the traffic. There are some issues with this, like if you have high workload on the switch, then if you have 1 gigabit here, and 1 gigabit here, it is per second, then this one would have to run at 2 gigabit per second, and that will simply not work because if it's a 1 gigabit connection. So you will actually need to make 2 mirror ports if you want to be sure you get all of it. Okay, so this gets shipped to some sort of system, some sort of network security monitor system or similar. Let's call it a collector. Yes. And this guy will then process it just the same way as the online process down here or the PCAP thing would do. It's basically the same you have here as you would have if you run, say, Wireshark here. You could run Wireshark on that guy if you want to. What else do we have? We could also have this scenario where we actually have a router. And this router will, of course, you know, ship stuff to the other interface. But a router is basically just a computer. So we can do exactly the same as we did before, where we have some sort of process running. Some sort of process running where we can ship it to PCAPs or some online tool. Normally you would, if this is a Juniper thing, you would do a monitor traffic, and you will be able to filter it so you don't see all of it and so on. And depending on that, there will be some hardware issues with the router about if it's in the data plane or the forwarding plane, and there will be some technical things. And as you can see, this process here, I have specified that it's actually connected to this interface here, because the stuff coming in or out of this interface will be different than the stuff going in and out of this interface, especially if it's a router with multiple interfaces. So you need to decide where to sniff, on which interface to sniff. Okay. And the final solution here would be to have some sort of tap, which basically is a piece of hardware. Let's be consistent with the coloring. This is a tap, and this is some hardware which is specialized in cloning traffic. So just like all the other things, this guy will actually send all of the this way still, but it will actually function like a mirror port, and then you can ship it to your collector. So this is the basic design you have. This tab, depending on the hardware you have, it might be as simple as a wireless device just listening in on all traffic. It could be something super elaborate as something non-invasive listening to optical fiber traffic. That will be in all price ranges, this one. This one will copy the traffic to some other interface. We could actually build one of these ourselves if we want to. Yes? So, just to mention it, this stuff here could also be that something we ship to the collector, just like we have over here. Yes. So we will have, the way we have drawn this diagram is that we have some sniffing thing going on in the client. We have some sniffing thing going on in the switch. We have some sniffing going on in the router. Hey, we could add this to the collector also, and the tap, and from the server also. So in this case, you will actually have that the collector would be collecting more or less 5 times the same traffic. And that would make sense in certain cases, because then you would have the software up here being able to differentiate the different things. Yes? So,
let's do a new page.
Okay, so PCAPs. When you have traffic on the wire between the server and the client, I inverted it this time, let's be consistent. When you have traffic going from the client to the server, you will have a lot of packages going one way, and you will have a lot of packages going the other way. So the PCAPs will be just like you will see in if you look at this in Wireshark, you will see this table of where you will have some source, and you have some destination, and you will have some, this would be the layer 2 stuff. You will have some source and destination. This would be the layer 3 stuff. And then you will have way more columns describing the content of the, if this were Wireshark. So Wireshark is just a super convenient way of showing these things, but basically it just shows every little package that have been on the wire. And it shows in a nice convenient manner with some nice filtering and so on. Just a comment about Wireshark. Wireshark has 2 filters. We have, I'm unsure about the correct word, but we have the pre-filter, which decides what to collect. And we have the visual filter, if you like, which what to show. So imagine that we are doing gigabit between these two devices, then having Wireshark processing all that would require insane amounts of extra work. And I can see that I have an issue with my video. Can we do like this? Yes, we can. So this would be what to collect and what to show. So the if we do gigabit traffic here, then we will be collecting so much and processing so much that we have an issue. So Wireshark, just like basically all the other collection tools, will be able to filter. So you might filter on specific IP addresses, on specific port numbers, or whatever you feel like. And then when you got all of it, then you can do some extra processing, when you do your analysis, you can look in the filtering. So, and then the big PCAP is basically just all this into a file. And so that would be lots of packages or frames, if you like. This is the direct stuff that we take one of these, and then we have an entry in our, what's it called? We take one of those, and then look. They're just consecutively in the PCAP file. This is actually a super nice format because it means that we can use SCAPI or something similar to just, you know, process each frame as we have collected them. And it gives you a lot of options to do this offline, especially if it's very process intensive. You will of course not do real-time responses if you do it offline, but then you need to do some filtering or, you know, have massive amounts of computer power. Yes. So, one last page. Just a summary. We have, you can sniff on the interface, which is what we usually do with Wireshark. You can do a mirror port, which is something we do on switches. We probably call it a mirror port if we do it on a router also, but then you will be employing the layer 2 part of the router normally. And then the last one would be this tab. I've never played with tabs because it's very specialized hardware. I would very much like to have one. We can actually, an interesting tab that I've seen is the throwing star, they call it. Looks like this. It actually has four interfaces. Oh, so traffic goes from here to here and back, just like normal. So you will have the server over here and you have the client over here. But then it also does the thing that it copies all the incoming up here and it copies all the incoming down here, which basically gives us the opportunity to put all this into some collector. I'm looking into getting one of these. So sniffing on interfaces is what we always do with the Wireshark. Mirror port is super nice if you want to look at the data and traffic in transit. And then the tab would be if you are unable to get into some of the normal network devices. Yes? That would be my take on sniffing for my scriptless version. So thank you for listening. Wrong button, sorry.